Hello friends, today we are performing an experiment to obtain VI characteristic of GUNN diode. The setup for obtaining VI characteristic is as follows. The apparatus required are GUNN power supply, GUNN oscillator, fixed attenuator, isolator, PIN modulator, frequency meter, mesh termination, and VSWR meter. The block diagram for obtaining VI characteristic of GUNN diode is as follows. GUNN power supply, which is used to give power supply to GUNN oscillator and PIN modulator. GUNN diode, it is invented by J.B. GUNN. It works in negative resistance region and it is used for low power oscillations. PIN modulator, it is used for producing a continuous amplitude modulated RF signal. It works in forward bias condition. Isolator, it is used for elimination of standing wave and propagation of wave in forward direction. Variable attenuator is used to provide attenuation of signal. Crystal detector. The PIN modulator provides modulation and crystal detection provides demodulation. Now, we will see an ideal characteristic of GUNN diode. To obtain ideal characteristic, we have to take readings of voltage and currents. As the band gap of GUNN diode is 1.43 electron volt, as we give the power supply, the electron travels from valence band to conduction band, due to which the mass of electrons get increases, results in decrease in mobility and also results in decrease in current. This effect is called transfer electron effect and responsible for the VI characteristic of GUNN diode. Now we will see the ideal characteristic of GUNN diode. As we see, initially the voltage and current both are proportional to each other. As the voltage increases, current also increases. But after a threshold value, we obtain a negative resistance region. Negative resistance region means as the voltage increases, the current decreases. Now, we will take some readings to prove this relationship of voltage and current. Here, we see a knob which shows voltage and current. Upward direction shows voltage while downward direction shows current. First, we have to generate a maximum power, which we shown in earlier videos. Now, we will increase the voltage from 0.5 volt to obtain the current reading. First, we will take voltage in our observation table and its respective current. From the interval of 0.5, we will take the reading of voltage and its respective current. At 1, we will obtain current of 78 mA. Now we will increase the voltage by 0.5. At which we obtain current is 100. Make sure your voltage will not increase above 9 volt and take similar reading at the interval of 0.5 volt. Now we will plot graph for this. The x-axis shows voltage while the y-axis shows current. By taking proper scale, now we will plot our readings on graph and join the obtained point. As we see from graph, initially our voltage is proportional to current and at 3 volt we get threshold. And then we obtain negative resistance region, means the voltage increases but the current decreases.